at the 18th chapter, beginning at the 20th verse. We are so excited that all of you are here today. After such as the weather was over the past couple of days, it's refreshing to see you in the building. So that now that we have assembled ourselves here, let's make sure that we humble ourselves and let the Spirit of the Lord have His way. Give honor to the Lord our God and to our Savior Jesus Christ. Thank God for Jesus. Holy Spirit, our guide and our comforter. Have me always to be in the company in the pulpit with my friend in our churches, Timothy, Mr. Harris, Antoine. Thankful for our ministry that God has poured into our hearts via our children. Ministry and dance and song. Y'all say amen. Make sure you encourage our children. Do you have the text? 1 Kings 8:20. Pray for me and pray with me that the Lord will have His way. Well, these words are recorded. So Ahab sent unto all the children of Israel and gathered the prophets together unto Mount Carmel. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, listen, how long y'all gonna be stuck between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow Him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people said not one word. Then said Elijah unto the people, I only remain a prophet of the Lord. But look around, you see Baal's prophets are 450 men. Let them now therefore give us two bullocks, and let them choose one bullock for themselves and cut it in pieces and lay it on wood and put no fire under. And I will dress the other bullock and lay it on wood and put no fire under. And call ye on the name of your gods. And I will call on the name of the Lord. And the God that answereth by fire, let him be God. Yes. And all the people answered and said, it is well spoken. Oh, y'all gonna talk now. Yes. And Elijah said unto the prophets of Baal, choose you one bullock for yourselves and dress it first, for ye are many, and call on the name of your gods, but put no fire under. They took the bullock which was given them, and they dressed it and called on the name of Baal from morning even unto noon.
Yes.
I heard him saying, oh, Baal,
yes.
Hear us. But there was no voice, nor any that answered. And they leaped upon the altar which was made, and it came to pass at noon that Elijah mocked them and said, hold on a minute, cry louder, for he is a God, right? Either he is talking, or he is pursuing, or he is in a journey, or peradventure he's sleeping, that maybe he must be awakened. And they cried aloud and cut themselves after the manner with knives and lances till the blood gushed out upon them. It came to pass when midday was past. They prophesied until the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice that there was neither voice, nor any to answer, nor any that regarded. Lord, have mercy to the people to give us that news. Of his divine word. As the Spirit of the Lord gives us evidence, I'd like to talk to you from this subject. All of this for damned stuff.
Don't let other folk around you dictate who you are.
the sanction of the crown.
Yes.
Baal had 450 prophets.
Yes.
Baal had so many scattered throughout the land. And Baal had been lifted up as being the true and the living God. And Baal confused me. As I go back to the crowd. I was confused. How can all of these people have it wrong? And just one old prophet have it right? How can we have come this far all of these years and watched all of these people who have become convinced? How can you hear the testimony of so many folk about how good Baal is and how he rescued them and how he provided them? How can you hear all of the singing and see all of the dancing and be in the temple and see how everybody is talking Baal? Not be convinced. Baal ain't nothing but a rock. I pause in my mind because so easily we make other gods real. Don't get it confused. I'm not talking about bowing down before some statue. I'm not talking about bowing down something made out of talk, out of stone. I'm not talking about bowing down to some physical being that we have made without a hand. There are those who do that, but I'm not talking about that. Don't you know how easy it is to give our time and our energy and our mind and our thoughts and our hearts and our offerings and our dinners and our sacrifices and our moments and become swept up in something that ain't? Eventually turns out to be just a damn block. In my own life, I don't mind testifying to you and telling you that if it ain't God, it ain't God. I know that may sound simplistic, but if it ain't God, it ain't God. It's not going to have the same characteristics of the true and the living God. I don't care how much you may imagine it. I don't care how much hope may testify about it. I don't care how much you're feeling it at the moment and how good it is. I don't care about none of those things. If it ain't the true and the living God, it ain't God. It's just a damn rock. And I'm not cussing.
Amen.
What I'm telling you is that rock is never going to be eternal. A rock is never going to be able to respond when you need it to. A rock is never going to be able to answer your prayer. A rock is never going to be able to carry you in the midnight hour and rock your soul to rest. A rock is never going to be able to lead you and guide you into ways of righteousness. And while you may be thinking I'm talking about just the rock, the reality is a rock is only symbolic of those things and those people who we allow in our become our gods. And most of us in here are guilty. As charged. We've allowed things of no value. Things of no value to control our lives. And I gotta tell you, I must admit to you that when I left Mount Carmel after everything was over, there was something on the inside that made me mad. I got angry because after all of these years and after all of the money that I've lost and after all of the time that I spent, all of the energy that I gave to Baal, Baal turned out to be just a damn rock.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying? Am I the only one in here who's ever lifted up a rock and made that rock call? I'm embarrassed. I am ashamed to tell you that I'm guilty as
charge. I've been the one that has placed the rock. I didn't try to. I didn't declare it. I didn't say, God, I'm going to replace you with a rock. But over time, the devil lied to me and told me that this rock was real, and it turned out to be just a damn rock.
Hold on. I had relationships that was just a damn rock. Say amen, God. God, it was all of that. God, it was going to fulfill me. God, it was going to complete me. God, it was going to bring me to the next level. And found out it was just a damn rock. And by the time I had found out it was just a damn rock, it had set on me and caused me to be broken. Called me to be crushed.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, God will let you bow down to a rock.
Yes.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes.
God will let you bow down to a rock. Don't get it wrong. God is a jealous God. He's already.
Double-minded. I was tired of flip-flopping. I was tired of trying to choose between one or the other. I wanted a mind that was made up. I wanted to know the answer. Will the real God please show up?
Amen. When Baal is your God,
yes,
he ain't gonna ever show up.
Alright.
Anything that you put above God.
That's right. Right.
Oh, yes. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. Anything that you erect over him. Anything that you give yourself to, anything that you just can't help but think about all of the time that ain't God. Won't show up.
Yeah.
I just knew that Elijah had it wrong. And I was expecting and almost excited because I knew that Baal was the enemy.
Yes.
I knew that the majority of the people seemed to be leaning towards believing that he was God. And Elijah seemed so confident.
Yes.
Amen.
You know, now I understand. You can be confident.
That's right.
When you have the real deal.
That's
amen. Right. Amen. I don't think I understand. You can be confident when you have the real deal. And that's why I believe that when times got tough, my mother and my grandmother didn't have to fear. They could just say, don't worry, he may not come when you want him, but he always
on time.
In their eyes, even if my father lost his job, yes, even if things got tight for him, yes, even if it didn't seem like he was going to pay our bill, yes, then how is he going to feed all of these children? Yes. One way or the other, God opened up a door, yes, and you made a way. That's how you know that you ain't just bowing down to some damn rock.
Yes.
I believe you ought to be confident, hey, when you're on the loss. You ought to be bold and audacious. You ought to be brave and ready to step up to the mic. You ought to be able to look the temptation to roll away in the eyes and maybe you used to trick me like that. But you ain't got me no more because I'm still on the rise that answers me when I hope.
Yes,
bold enough. Folk look at you in the eyes and, child, I don't know how you do it. You say because you don't know God, I
said.
You've been there time and time again. Others say, well, they tell you all the time, don't you? They tell you about them damn rocks that they've been leaning on. That damn rock told me he was going to help me pay my bills. Bye. He has already assured us that the righteous shall not be found begging for bread. He's already told us that we're more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. He's already assured us that weeping endures for the night, but joy comes in the morning. He's already let us know that this too is going to pass. So I ain't got to lean on my understanding, and I don't have to run after some damn rock. I told you I was thinking. When the time comes in your life where God brings you to Mount Carmel.
That's right. Amen.
Mount Carmel is the time in your life where God has finally said to you, I'm tired of you being double-minded. Some of you ain't ready for Mount Carmel.
Amen.
I ask the Lord, why?
Yes.
Why are they not ready for Mount Carmel?
Oh,
he said, because they are still romancing the stone.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear what I'm saying. You're still romancing the stone. And as long as you're romancing the stone, as long as you continue to bow down, you're not open to God's word in your life. You're not open because your mind is still blinded. You have a fetish for the foolish.
Yes.
That's the reason why it is you haven't come to Mount Carmel.
Yes.
Because you've run away from your mama.
Yes.
You've run away from your father's good instruction. You don't want to hear the old preacher preaching. You don't go to church no more. That may have been in your mind that you're going to try to fix this thing yourself. And every time you try to fix something that is broken and that can never be fixed, you are wasting your time. So I came by to tell somebody in here, you need to stop romancing the stone and realize that the stone ain't nothing but a damn rock. I was on Mount Carmel. Let me help you see what happened in the moment. 450 preachers dressed in priestly robes. They had come and in order to show the entire nation that Elijah was wrong.
Yes.
Let me help you see the dynamics of this. You can be in a room that is completely flooded with darkness. Can I get a witness here?
Amen.
But if you ever turn on one pin light, even in life today, that's a way of honoring God. And got two bullets.
Yes.
Amen.
Elijah got one.
Mm-hmm. To offer to his God.
That's right.
Yes, he did.
And then 450 prophets.
Yes.
Got another bullock.
Yes.
In order to offer to their God.
Yes.
And Elijah said, I tell you what, and I saw that preacher. I saw him cocky. I saw him confident. I saw him bold. I saw him as he told all of those men. And I thought to myself, he must truly be crazy.
Yes,
he is. Oh, they're gonna kill him.
Yeah.
When they show him up.
That's it.
Some of you got to be bold enough to put down your life.
That's right.
Amen. Because any man that lay down his life for the Lord's sake is the one that shall gain it. But the one that is afraid to lay down his life for the Lord's sake, that's the one that shall lose it.
Yes.
I'm going to close him.
Yes. Amen.
That prophet told them, go ahead and go first.
That's it.
All those men got together around the altar.
Yes.
Go first.
They had some church sex.
Yes.
Go up, amen.
That's how they began to praise.
Yes.
Some began to shout.
Yes.
Yamakazaki. Oh yeah.
awesome. Come down and represent by fire. Oh, yeah. I saw them all day long in the morning crying out so bitter. Oh, Lord. But touch your neighbor and tell your neighbor.
Go wake up and take truth and run with it.
mercy. But I saw it alive. Stepping up to the altar. All Baal's prophets were laid to shame. All Baal's prophets were embarrassed. I heard them saying, come down and dig a trench around the altar. Come down and lay down stone. Come down.
But my made up mind is that I am only going to bow down and will do it
daily. Serve. God so loved the world.
Yes.
He gave his own begotten.
Yes.
That whosoever believeth on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Tell me something. Is your life in God's
hands? Yes.
Yes. Daily am I bowing down, seeking his face, following his word.
Yes.
Am I weighed down by just some bad stuff? Many people will testify to you.
Amen.
That a stone, anything that ain't gone,
right,
it's going to fit.
Oh, yes.
But everybody who knows
that's it,
the true and the living God,
yeah,
will tell you to put your trust,
right,
in the Lord.
That's right.
Is it right when I tell you that heaven and earth, may pass it on?
Yes.
God's word.
Say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?